each of all here again. We're going to take a walkthrough, annual walkthrough of Constellation Andromeda. You can see that once again, the CIG has done a pretty good job of modeling this, putting a lot of detail. All the fancy. A lot of polygons, I believe. Yep. Merlin sitting back here. Not in the game yet, but I guess she'll be usable come 3.0 whenever it hits. Got a little bit of everything. Three docking ports, one on top, one on each side. See the bottom trend there. Cockpit full of glass, a lot of visibility. So the detail was just pretty much amazing. Nobody can complain about that. Getting into some of these hatches on some of these ships are not quite right, but I'm sure they'll work them out. They all work better. Same way with them getting into some of the seats in here. You have to get way underneath the hatch and open it, then you have to back up, or it'll flip, and it drops down on you. So there's another bug I'm sure they'll fix on. Go up on the ship here. Me that I was squashing it, but what do I know? Go around here and go up the front compartment and start at the front. Once again, a whole lot of detail. Got front turrets here, we're going to top and bottom. Get into them, just look down to hit the bottom one, hit your F key. I'm a little surprised there's not a rear turret on this vessel. Protecting your six. Awfully important, but obviously that's not going to happen in the game. Not if I'll make that big a change. We've got this bottom gunner doesn't have a whole lot of visibility, but can't really move around yet because it's in the hangar. Check out the top turret. Same thing, I'm going to look up and put the top chair down. Well, I'm sure that's the animation to get the amount of seats. There we have it. Look around, a lot better visibility up here than we had down below. Sometimes that can be a chore, getting right in the right sweet spot. Keeps wanting to go to pilot. This little bug, I'm sure it'll fix. Like either co-pilot seat pretty much has access to all the controls to help the pilot just fly it itself. Shield power, missiles and weapons up there. I'm sure you can switch them when you're out in PU. You can't do it here in the hangar. Pretty good visibility. Center seat. definitely built for at least a four-man crew. You can fly it solo, but you're not going to survive very long if you get attacked by pirates.
Robert Space Industries. Enjoy the ride. System
it's
check.
A big boat, so it's like it's going to turn all the time. Excellent visibility of this ship. It's got better than a fighter craft. And the other seat. Oh, look at that. Hit it right off the bat. Set up static and shield, but I'm sure if only one co-pilot's needed, I imagine you could have two, have one completely on a shield, the other one on power. Now head back to the second section of the ship. Three quarters, I guess we'll call it. Hatch up there, airlock. We have a table here, but no way to use the table. You can sit down, and it'll act like it's a table came up, but I have not seen a table. It may work out for me, I don't know. But we will get a use key here somewhere. Step in the right spot, there it is. We will take a seat, put our hands up on the invisible table. Just another minor bug, doesn't hurt a thing. Once you're in the seat, you can't do much of anything. Just look around and see if you want to try it. Shower, bathroom, can't open it, can't access it right now. Access the lockers. I guess you can hang clothes in there if you see the shoes. I don't know if we're going to be allowed to do that or not. I don't know why else we have where we can open the clothes. If we couldn't utilize them, we have four bunks. As I said, three or four. They also double as escape pods, I understand. Got five people on board and you're wanting to save out the PU, I can see that being an issue. Now we're looking at the cargo. It will hold, I understand, a MRSA. How much space is left over after you put a MRSA in here, I haven't complained about it. Probably still working that out. Carries quite a few missiles. I would imagine it gets real expensive reloading this stuff. Control pad here. Cargo hold, drop it, open it, load it. Understand the cargo hold on the TARS of the Connie is about twice as big. It'll actually hold two Ursas. Now we're going to the aft section. This is where the Merlin's kept. I guess this is cut out for the TARS, your cargo hold. No, haven't seen one. Must have known it's in game. You can't fly the Merlin yet, but you can get in it. I do understand the N3O, it will be in the game already, so you'll be able to use it. Just found it at 2.6. To say the detail put in these is amazing. Nobody can complain about that. Maybe a few bugs, a few glitches. Really worked hard detailing out everything. She probably slowed everything down. Got to get on this elevator quick or it drops in a hurry. Walk back through here. detail is just amazing. And we'll walk aft, and there's a Merlin tucked up in the aft. Held on. And there you have it. That's the Constellation Andromeda. A full walkthrough of what we have so far.